I've been always interested in science. I got very much into combustion because I think it's an intellectually challenging problem. You can imagine in combustion, you have chemistry and you have fluid mechanics. Each subject is very rich in science. This also have very strong engineering implications and applications. It's a hard problem, it's an important problem, that's why I wanted to be working in this area. So still now, 80% of the global energy production is from the combustion of fossil fuels. So how do we do the transition from the heavy dependence on fossil fuels to renewable energy with storage? So my group is really targeting these three areas, building up the fundamental knowledge on combustion processes. Second is to develop alternative fuels and metal combustions to replace fossil fuels. And the third is to have this flame-based synthesis that can bring down the cost of generating battery materials. I was first introduced to flame synthesis in my junior year in college. At that time, I realized you can actually burn things to make things. That was really fascinating. So I wanted to study why and how does particles formed in flame. Flame synthesis, this technology actually can be dated back 3,000 years ago in ancient China. This is a primary way of making the black ink materials. So what people did was burn down vegetables or woods such that afterwards they can collect the solidified smoke on the wall. For our battery applications, we can try to fit in the same formula, but of course with new tweaks. We develop a technology called a flame-assisted spray pyrolysis. So in short, it's called a FASP. We aim at fast synthesis of lithium-ion battery cathode materials. The cathode material for lithium-ion batteries contribute to 30% to 50% of the cost of the battery. The primary target for us is to come up with scalable manufacturing methods to reduce the cost of producing battery materials. We are also very interested in developing alternative fuels, such as metals. Aluminum, for example, have been used for solid rockets. Nowadays, we are interested in utilizing aluminum as a fuel for civil applications because aluminum is really abundant in Earth and it's cheap and it's available to all the countries. What we are trying to do is to understand different regimes that aluminum combusts and be able to tailor its ignition and propagation properties. When I was a small kid, when I watched TV shows, I always got very interested in detectives, and I wanted to be one of them. I feel that by doing research, we are sort of like detectives. We are unfolding many interesting science and be able to leverage that. We can also see a greater impact in our daily lives, in our society, and that's what keeps me going in the scientific field.